Take a moment and think about your favorite food. What might come to mind are foods like ice cream, pizza, cheese, curds, all great foods. And say you eat that food. You digest it, absorb its vitamins and minerals, and probably also more sugar or fat than you need. But wait, you are not the only one digesting the food that you eat. You are also feeding your gut microbes. And what would you say your average gut microbe would say is its favorite food? Now, foods like broccoli or Brussels sprouts might not be your favorite, but they might be exciting to your gut microbes. This is because they're high in fiber. And when you eat high fiber foods, such as leafy greens, broccoli, or whole grains, your gut microbes are very happy. And they eat up that fiber and poop out little compounds called short-chain fatty acids, little gifts to you that contribute to the health of your gut, immune system, and even brain. Now, you might be wondering, can gut microbes have a substantial impact on organs that are far from the gut, like the brain? Several studies have found that yes, changes to your gut microbes can cause measurable changes to your brain. Some microbes, when introduced to the gut of mice or humans, improve brain function, such as memory. This suggests that changes to your gut microbial friends may be promising for diseases such as Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease is currently the seventh leading cause of death in the United States, and is affecting more and more people as the population ages. Likely many of you in this room know a friend or family member with Alzheimer's disease, and can see how it affects their basic functions and connections with people. Despite this, we still have no cure and few treatments for this devastating disease. My thesis aims to find out if short-chain fatty acids are associated with risk for Alzheimer's disease, and to explore if these compounds could help prevent or even treat the disease. But how can you measure levels of these compounds in the gut of a living person? It turns out, your number two is actually number one for getting to know your gut microbes. Participants in an Alzheimer's disease study generously donated poop samples, and I measured levels of short-chain fatty acids in the samples. First, I looked at levels in healthy people, and second, in people at risk for Alzheimer's disease. I found that in people at risk for the disease, there are fewer short-chain fatty acids in the poop or in the gut. Could this mean that short-chain fatty acids could help people with Alzheimer's disease? This research has shown the connection between these gut microbial compounds and Alzheimer's disease in people, and my next step will be to explore if giving short-chain fatty acids can help prevent or even treat the disease in mice. So next time you're hungry for your favorite snack, consider feeding your gut microbes a fiber treat. They just might reward you with little gifts for your brain.